For the majority of 2022, I always thought the Sonic the Hedgehog 2 was my favorite film of the year. That would make sense since I'm a huge Sonic fan. Don't get me wrong, there are so many great movies I saw this year, like The Woman King, Top Gun Maverick, Avatar The Way of Water, The Boss Burgers movie, and more. But alas, I preferred Sonic 2 as my favorite film of the year for the majority of it. That was until I saw Steven Spielberg's newest film, The Fabelmans. And it is the best film of 2022, and dare I say it, it is a true cinematic masterpiece. Now, I don't normally make videos on these type of movies, so I mostly talk about animation, but in this movie's case, I knew I had to talk about it. Also, there will be spoilers in this video, so if you haven't seen the movie yet, I highly recommend you skip this video and come back after you've seen the movie. Now, without further ado, let's explain on why The Fabelmans, in my opinion, is a cinematic masterpiece. Part 1, The Story. Now, before we talk about the story, I think it's important to point out that this movie is loosely based on Spielberg's own childhood and his first few years as a filmmaker. Okay, now let's talk about the story. The movie is about a kid named Sam Fabelman who wants to become a filmmaker thanks to his parents, Bert and Mitzi, taking him to see his first movie, The Greatest Show on Earth. However, when he grows into a teenager, things become harder for him as his relationship with his family begins to sour. Especially between him and his mom after he finds out that she and Bert's best friend Benny begin to have feelings towards each other. Now, on paper, this might seem like a typical coming-of-age story, this time based on Spielberg's childhood. However, it all but makes up for it in execution. I think Spielberg really succeeded at making what seems to be just a typical coming-of-age story and actually making it both great and impactful in execution. And it is especially done well with its emotional core, successfully making you feel for the characters, especially for both Sammy and his mother. Overall, the film really succeeded at taking this typical story and making it really impactful and great. Part 2, The Characters. I liked pretty much every character in this movie, mostly due to the actors giving a phenomenal performance. The best character in the movie is definitely Sammy, and not because he's the main character, but because the movie succeeds at making you feel sorry for him, and it also succeeds at making some people relate to him, like myself. But pretty much all the characters in this movie are great, especially Mitzi, mostly due to Michelle Williams' fantastic performance. I swear to God, Academy, if you don't nominate her for Best Actress, I will hunt you down. And finally, Part 3, The Cinematography. The cinematography here is downright outstanding. This is definitely some of the best cinematography I have seen in a Spielberg film. The best part of the cinematography here is definitely the camera shots. Like, no joke, there are some downright beautiful camera shots in this movie. Especially in the ending where we see Sammy happily walking through the studio lot. Overall, The Fabelmans is a masterpiece of a motion picture. To me, it is up there as one of Spielberg's best films, and it definitely deserves the title of the best movie of 2022, and will live on for generations to come.